again, everybody. Thank you all for taking the opportunity to hear us out. One of the things I like to lead every pitch that I do with is to say thank you, as well as give everybody my perspective on the collaboration and what has really become an incredible space in the blockchain community. When we started this adventure, you know, a few months back, probably about 6 months ago at this point, it was just me and an 18-year-old developer at the time. And we've been fortunate enough to have enough resources, you know, put in front of us, and enough people willing to open their networks and, you know, be willing to help out. So coming from the traditional business space, it's very refreshing to see what's happening in the blockchain community. And so I would encourage all of you to continue to collaborate, continue to invite your friends, your family, different people to these events so that we can grow this truly extraordinary space. So DigiBuild, one of the things that we're trying to solve is real world use cases. You know, we talked earlier about these ICOs and about all these companies that got funded millions and millions of dollars for basically not having any product. And you look at the market, the cryptocurrency market, you know, the first quarter of 2018, and it was absolutely, you know, a bloodbath. And you look at a couple of the cryptocurrencies that actually did well, and the ones that did well were the ones that were doing things, meaning announcing partnerships, building things, building out their code. So there's one called VeChain, and I believe they were one, I think they were the only cryptocurrency that actually grew in the first quarter of 2018. And that has a lot to do with the maturation of the markets, like we talked about earlier on our ICO panel. You know, the markets kind of looked around and saw, you know, what is all of this that we overbought that has no technology, you know, no real world use case behind it. So what we're trying to do with DigiBuild, or what we're going to do with DigiBuild, is integrate the power of blockchain, DLT, and smart contracts into the real estate construction industry. And to me, you know, when we are able to take this to a global scale, you know, meaning achieving mainstream adoption, it's going to be because we help the mainstream to understand what the real uses are of this technology that's got everybody buzzing. So if you look at the internet, you know, when it was first being adopted, it started with, you know, banking, it started with purchasing online, kind of fintech, and then it gradually, you know, seeped into the rest of the market. Well, that's what's happening in the blockchain space. That's what happens, you know, in any sort of big innovation. So DigiBuild is trying to put a real-world use case to smart contracts and blockchain by integrating it into the real estate construction industry. We believe that we're going to be the digital evolution of the building process. So the building process as it stands right now is a $10 trillion market. The global infrastructure is a massive part of our everyday lives that we may even overlook. You know, the house you live in, the hospital your kids were born in, schools, you know, hotels, everywhere you go is the global infrastructure. And in a market like that, you would think that it has a very high success rate, but you'd be dead wrong. 70% of projects right now fail, finish over budget, not on time, costing millions and millions of dollars. And the companies involved in these projects are basically, you know, in a war on any given project. My background is I own two construction companies, so I've seen the market for a long time. And with profit margins like 2 to 4%, there is very little flexibility. There's little room to succeed. So what ends up happening is all of these contractors basically have a, you know, me-first mentality, which leads to, you know, projects that finish late, projects that, you know, don't stay within the budget, you know, requirements. So it's a very, very tough industry right now. Add that to the fact that it is one of the slowest industries out there. Typical payment times are 30, 60, 90, 120 days. So that means as a specialty contractor, let's say you're hanging drywall on a project, you may be waiting 2-3 months until you get that money that's already been, you know, that you've already spent. So there is a big time lack of trust and a big time lack of cash flow in the industry. So you add those two things to the fact that all of these wasteful processes are up and down, you know, all over the project. You know, 60% of a project is waste. So how can we fix that? Well, what DigiBuild is going to do is implement smart contracts on the back end of any given construction project. And that's going to save up to 20% on the back end savings, reducing, you know, waste and bringing the, you know, labor output on the back end down. What we're also going to do is implement smart contracts to handle the payment settlement. And what we're able to do implementing smart contracts is take the settlement time from between 30, 60, 90, 120 days down to 5 to 7 days, which for SMEs, small to mid-level companies, that is a very big deal. Now, back to my point about how all these companies are not working together because profit margins are so small, everyone is kind of doing their own thing, trying to maximize their profit, not collaboratively engaging in trying to build something. So what DigiBuild is going to maintain is an incentive program that rewards all these contractors on any given project for doing things that are healthy business practices for the ecosystem. So what does that mean? We're going to have a reward system in place that dishes out bonuses for finishing a project early, for finishing a project under budget, for avoiding payment disputes. And what that's going to do is put the industry in the right direction as a cohesive unit, as opposed to these closed off systems where it's every contractor for themselves. Finally, what we're going to do is take all the results from the projects that are ongoing in our system. And so we have the smart contracts running, we have the incentive program dishing out these rewards. We're going to take the results of that and hash it into the blockchain and provide a user interface. And what that's going to do is provide credit profiles for all the companies that are out there trying to get this work. So one of the big problems that you encounter in today's market is secondhand data. There's really no way for you to know who you're hiring as a contractor. So let's say you're building a $20 million hotel. You need to know that the person that's building that hotel is actually capable of doing that. And if they don't, are we running out of time? 1 minute?
We're over, but
okay.
That's my, want to open up for a quick question or so?
Sure. We're implementing credit and reputation management, and that will allow a new level of transparency so you can always see who is building for you, and that reduces risk, reduces cost, and makes it more likely that we're going to have a collaborative endeavor, a successful construction project. Any questions? No? Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Rob.
Thank you.